So, you want to be a mage. You found the right video. If you want to harness magic in New World, there's a few decisions that you need to make. The first and most important decision is the decision to scroll down a little bit and then like and subscribe. After that, you're going to want to go in and choose which weapon that you are going to use. Every time you level up your weapon, you're going to get a skill point, which you're going to be able to put towards different strengths that buff that weapon. This is also how you unlock the different abilities for each weapon. Don't be too afraid to spend these points, because up until level 20, you can respec for free, which means that you can get all your points back and respend them. But after level 20, it's going to cost you. All right, let's find the weapon that best fits your playstyle. If you decide to go with the fire staff as your weapon of choice, you're going to want to put all of your points into intellect to do the maximum amount of damage. As far as skill trees go, you're going to have two options, the fire mage and the pyromancer. Choose the fire mage and you're going to have three abilities to unlock. If you go with the fire mage, you're going to start with pillar of fire. How this ability works is you're going to cast out a small AoE ability that does big damage. The second ability that you're going to get is meteor shower. What this is going to do is cause an area of effect where meteors are raining in, and it does damage to all the enemies that are within its range. It doesn't do big damage, but it does damage the entire time that the enemies are inside of it. Lastly, you're going to unlock the ability to shoot out a fireball, which does big damage on impact and also sets the area around your opponent on fire, and it continues to do damage as they stay inside of it. Fire mages really thrive when they have someone else to take damage for them, as most of their abilities you want a stationary target for. If you have no one else to take damage for you, you may want to consider running heavier armor. This is going to lower your mobility, but it's not a huge deal because you're not going to be moving too much as a fire mage anyways. If you decide not to go with fire mage, then you're going to be choosing pyromancer. The first ability of this is flamethrower. It does basically exactly what it sounds like. It's going to shoot flames out the end of your staff, and it's going to burn the enemies. This is really short range, but it does damage to multiple enemies at once and also sets the targets on fire, which does damage over time. The next ability that you're going to unlock is incinerate. This is going to create a ring of fire around you that not only does big damage, but also pushes enemies away. On top of that, it also is going to set the enemies on fire, doing damage over time. Lastly, you're going to have my favorite fire staff ability, that is Burnout. Burnout is going to cause you to dash forward, doing big damage to any opponents that you hit. On top of that, every enemy that you hit is going to be burnt. Similarly to setting enemies on fire, this is going to do damage over time, but it's going to do more damage over time than just setting them on fire. This ability is really strong, especially if you hit multiple enemies with it. Pyromancers are really going to thrive at short range combat and also do really well against multiple targets. Because of this, you may want to take medium or light armor, because you can use that extra mobility while you're close range to dodge the incoming attacks. This is also going to allow you to set yourself up to hit multiple targets easier. Moving on from the fire staff, next up we are going to have the life staff for all of you healers out there. The life staff is the only weapon in the game that's going to scale with the focus attribute. This means the higher focus you have, the more damage and the more healing you're going to do. Taking the life staff, you're going to choose between two separate trees. This is going to be healing and protector. If you go with protector, your first ability is going to be orb of protection. This is not only going to do big damage to enemies, but if you hit a teammate, it's going to fortify them, making them take less damage, and it's going to heal them just a little bit. You're also going to get the beacon ability. You're going to shoot out a projectile that does big damage to the enemy and also attaches to them. And once attached to them, it's going to heal all allies that are near that enemy. The longer they stay next to that enemy, the more it's going to heal them. Lastly, you're going to unlock Light's Embrace. This is going to do big healing to whoever you target. You can choose your target by holding down the ability and using the scroll wheel to pick who you want to heal, or if you want to heal yourself, all you have to do is hit the control key. This ability is going to heal more for every buff you have applied to your target, so if you want maximum healing, you're going to really want to apply fortitude to your target before using this. If you go with the healing spec, your first ability is going to be similar to this. Divine Embrace is going to heal whoever you pick a good amount. You can decide whether you want to heal an ally or yourself. It works the same as Light's Embrace. Your next ability is going to be Sacred Ground. What this is going to do is cause a circle on the ground that if you or an ally is standing on, it's going to heal them. This lasts 15 seconds and heals more the longer that you're inside of it. This is great for healing multiple people at once. The last ability that you're going to get from the healing spec is Splash of Light. This is going to heal you and all of your group members within 100 meters, 50% of your weapon's damage. This is really good for group healing. Personally, if I was solo leveling, I would choose the protector tree, but if I'm leveling with a group or doing a lot of dungeons, I would go the healing route. It's really up to however you decide you want to play. I made sure to save my favorite weapon for last. This is the Ice Gauntlet. This weapon is going to scale with intelligence, so if you want to do max damage, put as many points as you can into your intelligence spec. If you're someone that's into having pets or having things that fight for you, you may want to go into the Builder skill tree. This is the closest thing that you're going to get to having pets. The first ability you're going to get with this is going to summon a pylon that is going to do damage for you and also take the threat away from you. It lasts a good portion of time, but it can die if it takes too much damage. The second ability you're going to get is Ice Shower. This is a crowd control ability that's going to create a curtain of ice between you and the enemy. If the enemy walks through this curtain, they're going to be stuck in place for 1 second and then slowed and unable to dodge for 3 seconds after that. This is going to be really good for making sure that no enemies can close that distance on you. The third ability that you're going to get is Entombed. This is going to create a pillar of ice around you that prevents you from taking any damage for 10 seconds. On top of this, you're going to regenerate mana really quickly. If you get in trouble and have too many enemies facing you, you can throw this up and let your pylon do a bunch of damage or let your teammates do damage while you're just sitting in this giant ice cube. If you're looking for a more kite-friendly build, you can run the Ice Tempest. This is my personal favorite spec. The first ability that you're going to get is going to shoot out a trail of spikes, and at the end of that trail, there's going to be a major spike. If you manage to hit somebody with the trail, it's going to do a little bit of damage, and if you hit them with the major spike, it's going to do big damage. This is really good if there's a lot of targets stacked right on top of each other. Your next ability is Ice Storm, which is going to create an area that slows enemies that enter it. It's also going to do damage to them the entire time that they're within the area. Put this between you and your enemy, and you're going to be able to do major damage before the enemy gets anywhere close to you. Finally, you're going to have Wind Chill. What this does is shoots out a short range burst of frost, similarly to how Flamethrower works, but what this is going to do is it's going to do damage and push enemies away from you. Once they're at max range away from you, this ability is going to do more damage. Like I said, this is my preferred build, and if you combine the Ice Storm ability with light armor, you're going to have a lot of mobility yourself, and you're going to be able to really effectively kite enemies around. This is a really fun high mobility playstyle that a lot of times the enemies aren't even going to be able to reach you before they die. Don't forget to like and subscribe if this video was helpful, and check out the Twitch stream down below. Thanks for watching.